Yep, we have a working camera. It's freezing bitter cold. Torrential rain on the job site, so luckily I have a rod in my car. We're going towards the Parramatta River and there's no rain. So let's give it a go.
Run out tide. And face mask on. There's no one here, so I can take my mask off.
Water looks good.
Is that there? Don't know. That doesn't look too good. Like no fresh chewing or anything. It is the time of year where they're out wide though. See how we go. Tide looks like it's running in. It is running in. Yep. Ah. I wish. First Parramatta rag, and it's a big one. Here we go. I'm gonna keep all my rubbish, put it in the bin. There's plastic, there's rags, and then there's brim. We're sort of after the brim. It's going to rain. It could mean they could be on the pipes, so I'll go check one. The camera keeps blowing out, so hopefully it'll run this time. The reason I'm here trying this pipe out is because of all the bird shit. The seagulls have been sitting on this point, or this pocket, I should say. Which means that all sorts of fish could be hanging out here too. I like being on my own. I'm walking around the streets of Sydney in COVID. I love it. The mangroves are budding. Sweet. It's pretty slimy. Always looking for those fresh chews. So far down this end, I can't find any. It's just slime. But there is shell grit down there, so there is brim in the area. And then there's a cloud of dirt. It's just shot off there. They're not just chewing on the rocks, they're just after the mussels. Hence my black blade. I really want to just sit in one spot, try and intercept the school of fish. This is as good a spot as any. I think there's a ferry coming up, so I'll just bunker down here for a while. It worked. I didn't get the big plate that I dropped, but I got a small one. Switched off the blade. Oh, I got a small brim. Even better. I switched off the blade and went I just put a big heavy, it's probably the dumbest soft plastic lure you could get, because I put a big heavy weight on it. And then I've just stuck a worm hook on the weight with a gold prawn. It's not even, like the hook point's turning, the prawn's sidewards when you retrieve it. But he's caught that, so that's pretty cool. I've got 19% battery, so let's see if I can get another one. Awesome. take you off, little man. So I've had two bites. One was a cracking flathead. And now I've just caught this little brim. So sort of pretty happy now. It's all about accomplished. Like, it's one thing to get a hook up, and then it's another thing to land a fish. Having both the hook up and the landed fish now, I'm pretty happy. Can you see? It doesn't even sit straight on the lure. I don't know if my camera's in line or not. Where are you? It just doesn't look right. It looks dumb. But this is the lure that's done most of the damage for me this season, this winter. It hasn't been the blades like usual. It's actually been this, just a fixed weight. Normally I've been using the TT ones. And the whole principle of it is just so it sinks into that mud. So it's basically just the prawn sticking out of it. Anyway, I apologise for not running the camera because I've got very little battery life, so I'll just turn you on with hookups. But all I'm doing, there's three retrieves. One's my Ermo Twitch like that. And one is a sweep like that. And the other is just absolutely, look, it's just shaking. And that compared to the Ermo Twitch has got a big rip. That one that I caught just come off a sweep. But I am mixing it up quite a bit. Oh, there's one. There's another one. Oh, definitely another brim. That was a... They're going to come on the bite and the battery's going to run flat. Here's a fixed head onto a worm hook. A little bit big too, by the way. Like, I should have had a size smaller. And then just a gulp prawn on the worm hook. And it's a very ugly presentation. But it spears out there like a bullet. Sinks straight to the bottom and leaves nothing but the prawn coming out of the mud. And that's the secret to its success. So far this year, this has probably been the standout lure on several different weight sinkers. So there you have it. Not much of a video, boys, but I've just been pretty busy working right through this autumn winter period, so I haven't had a chance to do much fishing, and that will change come spring. Thanks for watching, guys. I'm gonna create with this bait. It's like that sinker drops into the mud, and then what it is, it's like an animal dragging another animal into the mud, which just makes any predator just light up. Yeah, it's easy pickings.